It's not working.
Pearl, get over here.
I can't.
For Steven!
Steven Universe is my all-time favorite cartoon right alongside Adventure Time. I have plans for future videos where I'll properly gush about it and also defend its perceived flaws to my dying breath. But as you saw from the title, this video is just about one specific scene out of hundreds. So I'll try, keyword try, to stay focused. Play the clip.
Oh, look, I have what appears to be a delicious pie. I sincerely hope that nothing happens to... Oh, Steven!
Are you trying to kill him faster?
First of all, if you didn't previously know what I'm about to tell you, you better make sure you're sitting down. You just might become fully enlightened. The person who storyboarded this scene, Raven Mollisey, was once a board artist for Ed, Edd n Eddy. This explains a good chunk of the show's most expressive-looking moments, or depending on your political alignment, off-model moments. Even some of Steven Universe's character designs bear similarities to those seen in Ed, Edd n Eddy. Just look at Lars and Sadie, who happen to be some of Rebecca Sugar's first characters. You could plop them right into the cul-de-sac and you wouldn't say anything, besides how freakishly tall Lars is. Put Petey in there too, now we're talking. Is someone gonna write a fanfiction of this? Anyway, I know for a fact, without having to go into further detail, that Sugar is a huge fan of Ed, Edd n Eddy, so it must have been a dream to recruit them from there to Steven Universe. Luckily, the storyboards for this entire episode can be found on the good old Steven Crewniverse blog on Tumblr. So let's take a quick breeze through them before analyzing the final scene. Oh yeah, here we go. Arrows seem to be a board artist's best friend. Here, Raven used regular small arrows to guide the motion of specific body parts, like Steven's face. And here, three-dimensional arrows to show the desired direction and flow of the movement. Wait, didn't I already start breaking it down? Nah, whatever. There's a lot of smears in this scene. But my favorite one is when Amethyst throws down Pearl, her entire body acts like a smear. This is perfect. Moving on. Here it would have been nice to see some continuity by having bits of pie falling from this shot to this shot. But that's just a small oversight and is immediately made up for with the peak of this whole scene. When Pearl starts the motion of throwing her arms around Amethyst, there's a couple instances of the clown wig and pie being animated on alternating frames. This is a neat trick to make objects appear to move independently from the character. Also, you probably didn't notice this. The line thickness changes from this frame to this frame. That's to prepare for the truck out of the camera. Without that change, the lines would appear too thin once it's zoomed out. Finally, one thing that could describe why I love this snippet in particular is a concept in animation called overshooting. To make this action look satisfyingly bouncy, Amethyst was drawn a little past the final resting frame, which then settles to it. Here's what I mean visually, since I'm not great at explaining things. I have to mention a very important principle of comedy, and that is juxtaposition. It's a dark, gloomy afternoon, Steven is uncontrollably accelerating his own death, but to contrast this, you have all this wacky, cartoony motion, and Pearl just hilariously losing it. It goes without saying that Dee Dee's voice acting- It goes without saying that her voice acting adds so much to the scene, but there's one part in particular that's easy to tune out and miss. Like, what the? That's like leagues above a kid's show vocal performance. That's like an Oscar-nominated drama. I love how you'll hear examples of really raw voice acting in the infancy of some cartoons. Tell me that isn't the most genuine cough you've ever heard in a cartoon. Anyway. Thanks not only to Raven's art style, but her writing and scene building as well, the entire scene has big, big Ed, Edd n Eddy energy. The way Amethyst carries Pearl like a stiff board, there's a blink and you miss it of Amethyst latching onto Garnet's arm like a monkey, and just every single one of Pearl's faces in the scene. Especially this one. And that's it. Thanks for watching. I'm not sure if the next video will be another one of these or something different, but either way, stay tuned.
That was very poorly edited.